Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. In the name of God, most merciful, most beneficent, Your Excellency, Dr. William Samoei Ruto, the President of the Republic of Kenya and Commander-in-Chief of the Kenya Defense Forces. Allow me to say, like the Tanzanians say in Kiswahili, tukizingatia itifaki, all protocols observed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum. Yeah, that requires an answer because it is a greeting of peace and we need peace in this country. Your Excellency, it is with great honor and privilege that I stand before you today on behalf of a committee that is called the Sharia Advisory Committee of CPF Saleh to make these remarks. Today, we are marking this momentous occasion, the bell ringing ceremony for the Lindsay Sukuki bond, the first Sharia compliant investment product, not only in this country, but in the region. As we all know, Sukuk is a Sharia compliant financial instrument that offers a viable alternative to conventional debt financing. This innovative investment offers a powerful platform to mobilize resources, stimulate economic growth, and create shared prosperity. The introduction of the Lindsay Sukuk into our market unlocks new avenues for investment, expands our financial toolkit, and paves the way for a more inclusive and resilient economy. Your Excellency, Islamic finance offers an innovative blend of stability and potential growth. They provide investors with medium to long-term opportunities to earn consistent returns while mitigating risks associated with excessive speculation. Unlike conventional financial tools, these instruments are rooted in the principles of shared risk and reward, ensuring that funds are directed towards tangible, productive assets. This approach stimulates sustainable economic growth through a just and equitable system of fairness, transparency, and social responsibility. The Lindsay Sukuk is more than a mere financial instrument. It is a beacon of novelty in our markets. This pioneering investment vehicle, will make a substantial contribution to Kenya's economic landscape, inshallah. By directing investment towards the construction of over 3,000, I repeat again, over 3,000 affordable residential units for the Kenya Defense Forces, this Sukuk directly addresses a pressing national challenge, the housing deficit. This exemplifies the transformative potential of Islamic finance, demonstrating its capacity to tangibly enhance societal welfare and economic progress. Your Excellency, sir, this landmark event is a testament to the growing recognition and acceptance of Islamic finance in Kenya. It signifies a shift towards a more inclusive and diversified financial environment. We applaud the efforts of the regulators, the Capital Market Authority, the Retirement Benefits Authority, our issuers, and all the stakeholders involved in bringing to life the Lindsay Sukuk bond. This alternative provides an opportunity for diversification opportunity for investors who wish to invest in socially responsive investments in Kenya. Ethical finance is not just a niche market, but a viable, sustainable, and profitable approach to economic development. Your Excellency, Sukuk is an alternative investment process. Sukuk as an investment alternative possesses the potential to revolutionize our financial landscape. This instrument empowers financial institutions to optimize their portfolios, manage risk effectively, and generate Sharia-compliant returns. It is a testament to the compatibility of Islamic finance with contemporary economic realities. Let us therefore commit ourselves to nurturing this burgeoning industry by fostering innovation, collaboration, and a conducive regulatory environment. We can unlock the full potential of Islamic finance to serve the best interest of our nation and its people. And to highlight other notable projects financed through this Sukuk, that we are not the only people. Other countries have made it through Islamic bonds or Sharia-compliant bonds. We can make it, Your Excellency. As an example, in South Africa, the city of Johannesburg issued a Sukuk bond worth $500 billion to support urban infrastructure development, specifically targeting improvements in public transportation and waste management. If they made it, why not Kenya? In Dubai in 2009, the Dubai Metro Sukuk bond was issued to fund the expansion of Dubai Metro network, enhancing the city's public transport infrastructure. In Malaysia, the Kuala Lumpur International Airport Phase 2 issued a Sukuk in 2013. They issued it to finance the expansion of the airport, facilitating increased passenger capacity and modernized facilities. In Saudi Arabia, in 2016, Saudi Aramco issued a $10 billion Sukuk to support a range of infrastructure and energy projects throughout the country. If these countries have succeeded, why can't we succeed? I believe, inshallah, we can succeed. Your Excellency, finally, we can play an integral role in nation building. This is just the beginning, and we thank CPF and Diazone for this great step. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this endeavor and grant it success. May He guide us all towards a future where finance is not merely a means to an end, but a tool for building a better world for generations to come. And before I conclude, Your Excellency, it has taken teamwork for us to be here. You heard that there is a team of experts from outside who advised us to ensure that we are Sharia compliant. Internally at CPF, Dr. Keely has put together a team, which I lead, of Sharia scholars. We are three of us. One of us is not here, is a lady. She's Dr. Manakitina Bakari. She's not feeling well. She's in Mombasa. And my other colleague is here, Dr. Sheikh Muhammad Shakul, if you could just stand up. We have the expert internally, and Dr. Keely has made the efforts of taking us to Malaysia so that we can also learn how they do it. We also have a young man, I think he's not a Gen Z, I think he's a millennial. Abdullahi Hussein, if you are here, if you could stand up. I think Dr. Keely has a lot of trust in this young man. He is the one that is heading the Sharia compliant window at Saleh, CPF Saleh. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, fellow Kenyans, all this cannot be achieved if we do not have peace. Your Excellency, we want peace in this country, and I want to take this opportunity as a religious leader in this country, that there is a formula for bringing change. Your Excellency, when we have a problem, the formula is we do not solve a problem by creating a bigger problem. We should solve problems by looking at solutions that will not create bigger problems. We can make it if there is peace. May God Almighty bless us with peace in this country. Thank you.